A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Paul's escorts had taken him to Athens, they came away with instructions for Silas and Timothy to join him as soon as possible. Then Paul stood up at the Areopagus and said, "You Athenians, I see that in every respect you are very religious. For as I walked around looking carefully at your shrines, I even discovered an altar inscribed to an unknown God. What therefore you unknowingly worship, I proclaim to you, the God who made the world and all that is in it, the Lord of heaven and earth, does not dwell in sanctuaries made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands because he needs anything. Rather, it is he who gives to everyone life and breath and everything. He made from one the whole human race to dwell on the entire surface of the earth, and he fixed the ordered seasons and the boundaries of their regions, so that people might seek God, even perhaps group him for and find him, though indeed he is not far from any one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since therefore we are the offspring of God, we ought not to think that the divinity is like an image, fashioned from gold, silver, or stone by human art and imagination. God has overlooked the times of ignorance, but now he demands that all people everywhere repent, because he has established a day on which he will judge the world with justice through a man he has appointed. He has provided confirmation for all by raising him from the dead." When they heard about resurrection of the dead, some began to scoff, but others said, "We should like to hear you on this some other time." And so Paul left them. But some did join him and became believers. Among them were Dionysius, a member of the court of the Areopagus, and a woman named Damaris, and others with them. After this, he left Athens and went to Corinth. Verum Domini. Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all you angels. Praise him, all you his host.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Let the kings of the earth and all the peoples, the princes and all the judges of the earth, young men too and maidens, old men and boys.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His majesty is above earth and heaven.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
He has lifted up the horn of his people. Be this his praise from all his faithful ones, from the children of Israel, the people close to him.
Thank you. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Lectio Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
Jesus said to his disciples, I have much to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears, and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me, because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason I told you that he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Verbum Domini. You know, many of us watch films, and there's always very quotable lines in them. And there was one movie that has some lines in there that is one of the most quoted in cinema history. And this comes from a movie called A Few Good Men. And it is when there was some kind of a military official on trial, and he's being questioned by a lawyer. And the lawyer says, I want the truth. Give us the truth. And so the military official says, you can't handle the truth. See? And, you know, there are many of us who can't handle the truth. We may think we can, but often we can't. And this is why Jesus says today to the disciples, he says, I have many things to tell you, but you cannot handle them now. And so, you know, Jesus has many things to tell us further. He's always speaking to us through the Holy Spirit. And he calls us to listen with open hearts. Well, he's here to help us today. You know, this is a struggle. It's not easy to handle the truth. It's not easy to take it in. But with the grace of God, we can do all things. And so, like, we look here at the disciples and the scene here. Here is, again, the Last Supper. Jesus is speaking to them about what is about to happen. He's giving them instruction. And now he says that I have much to tell you. You can't bear some of it right now. Well, let's take a deeper look here. Okay, at the same scene, we had Jesus say that somebody was going to deny him. Somebody was going to betray him. And then Peter gets up, and all of them are kind of discussing among themselves, well, it's not me. And all of this, and St. Peter would get up and say, well, I'll never, never forsake you, never deny you. Jesus says, you will deny me three times. And of course, Peter objects to this. Oh, no, I never will. But what happened? He did. See, he couldn't recognize this truth about himself. Jesus saw through him. He couldn't receive it at the time. You know, and he says, well, I love you, I'll do anything and die for you. But he really didn't have that type of love. And he didn't come to receive this truth until after he had suffered much following the suffering and crucifixion of Jesus. When Jesus resurrected, then they have Jesus came to him, they have a conversation. It's, Peter, do you love me? Then Peter has to admit that, yeah, I do love you, but it wasn't with this agape love, this all-giving, self-sacrificing love. It was with a brotherly love. He says, yeah, I do love you, and he admits it. He's truthful here. But he wasn't ready, he wasn't ready to receive this truth at this time. Now, St. Paul addresses the Corinthians in First Corinthians chapter 3, right at the beginning. And he's telling them that he has to give them milk, that they're not ready for solid food yet. And the reason is because they're in their flesh, they're in the flesh. You know, they're still holding on to things of the world, though this church of Corinth has already received the Lord and they're already serving him. They're still not ready to receive all truth because they're still under the influence of the world. So they can't be open to the truth. And the evidence is here, there, is that they're fighting amongst themselves. No, they're bringing in worldly habits into the church. So that's why Paul says, you're just not ready for solid food yet. I have to give you milk, a little bit at a time. In the book of Hebrews, it says sort of the same thing, where the author is addressing the people, and he says that, hey, by this time, you should be teachers. You know, you should be going and teaching and evangelizing, out, going out and all this. He says, but you're not. You still need milk. You're not ready for the meat. Well, all of us, we need to be ready for the meat, but we can't handle it all at once. You know, just like, of course, like a baby. Before a baby can have solid food, they have to drink milk, drink formula, eat a soft diet, and eventually they can have the meat. See, all of us, you know, we should all desire to have everything that God gives us. God, the Lord, wants to give us so, so much. And ultimately, we are called to love as we see in the Blessed Trinity. And the Holy Spirit is revealing this to us, but of course, it has to come gradually. In order for us to love as God has called us to love, we have to accept certain truths. And this is hard for us. It's not easy to hear the truth about ourselves. No, we become stubborn. We become hard-hearted. There are many of us who have been in the church for many years serving God, and we're not going anywhere. Why? Because we're stubborn. And oftentimes, like St. Peter, like I spoke about earlier, you know, God has to kind of break us a little bit, break the heart so that he can come in. But, you know, we need to be ready for this. Welcome this, the truth of God. Now, and just for example, in stubbornness, you know, sometimes this could be in the area of relationships, certain bad habits, vocational things. I know it was my vocation thing. I remember, you know, I was a little stubborn and didn't see things. I remember I went to the doctor once and told him I had an interest in a career as a first responder, as a police officer, firefighter. And he looked at me and says, that's not for you. You're only interested in that because you want the excitement of that life. And he was right. 10 years later, I realized this. Okay, not ready for vocation as a priest. And people were telling me. But I just couldn't handle it then. I needed had to experience certain things. It happens. Well, how do we become more acceptable to these truths of God? Well, of course, our prayer, having time with the Lord, studying the Word, opening ourselves up to it, not putting a block there immediately. Well, I just can't do this. No, this is not for me. No, and then also docility, being teachable. It says, okay. Yeah, I'm going to be teachable. I'm going to let them teach me. I'm going to let the truth come in. Well, sometimes there are some truths that are just that are hard to bear. Some of us are thinking, well, I just can't do that. I just can't live that. I don't know how. Well, that's why we have to pray. We pray for the grace. It says, God, help me to accept this. Help me to bear the truth, to live the truths of the church, to make it my own, to assent to them. And he will. He will give us the grace over time. No, and accepting these truths, of course, the teachings of the church, but even the truths about ourselves and the truths about our life is very necessary, especially if we want to grow in the Lord, want to advance in the spiritual life. Sometimes we need to face certain truths so that we can be healed from things. You know? And that can be very scary when it involves abuse, when we are a victim to anything. You know, we have to speak about these things at times to be consoled and to get certain advices to help us move on so we don't have to live in that nightmare anymore. But we need to talk about it, get healing. Oftentimes, you know, a lot of this is through a good confession. Some of us don't want to go to confession. We don't want to admit what we did or acknowledge that we were wrong. You see, when we speak it out, it comes out, gets out of us. It hurts, but it's just like a sickness we may have. You know, when you're sick and you got something disease in you, of course, you feel all the symptoms and, oh, something's wrong. And then it starts coming out of your body. And sometimes that can be very painful. You got sweats and vomiting and all of this stuff, but it's coming out and it hurts. Same with the things that we have to admit at times, to bring surface. We have to face certain truths. They're coming out. But it's good because then we can be healed and be set free, move on. You know, Jesus says, you know, himself, who is all truth, he will make us free. He will set us free. So we got to be willing to receive all of that. And yeah, though difficult, God is always there to help us with the power of his grace, with the love of the Lord. We don't have to fear this. We don't have to fear the truth because in the truth there is love. Why does God give us these truths? Because he's angry or upset with us or because he wants us to have a boring life? No, he gives this to us because he loves us. Because this is the way we were made to live in his truths. You know, that's why he gives them to us. It's all love here. The truth is because of God's love on us. And he wants us to grow in this love because this is ultimately his will. He knows what's best for us, better than what we know for ourselves. But it begins by our willingness to be humble, to be docile, and to receive these holy truths of God so that we can be set free, so we can walk in peace, in liberty of God. That's why the prophet says that he would set the captives free, you know, free from sin and death. There's so much that could be weighing on us right now. We can feel like we're prisoners. We can just feel like we're incarcerated all the time by certain, maybe our mistakes or by just like in the life we're living. But God is calling us today to receive him, to take his truths. Because he wants to make us free. He wants to set the captives free. So today, brothers and sisters, I mean, if it's how difficult it is, it can begin as easy as this. He says, Lord, just help me to receive your truths. Show me how. Make a way for me. Send the people. Give me the messages I need to take it all in. And over time, he will. And he will give us peace. We can be set free and walk as we're called to walk, like Jesus Christ, Christ-like, like him. God bless you all.